Hey everybody, I'm Rob.
I'm LorriMarie Jenkins.
And I'm Jennifer.
And we are
moving to Costa Rica.
Except I'm not moving to Costa Rica because I'm just visiting from Malaysia.
Yes.
Two-thirds of us are moving.
That's right. Well, three-quarters of us.
Three-quarters.
Don't forget us.
So Jennifer's here just for one quick week visiting from Malaysia.
And who is Jennifer?
And Jennifer is my baby sister, so can't get enough of her, and I'm sad that she's going away so quickly. But we will visit in the future.
Yes,
so absolutely. And she is going to be our spokesperson, so to speak, today. She's going to ask us some questions, and we will answer them according to what's going on now. And we're artists that live in Vallejo, California.
Did I forget that one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's okay. Everybody knows. All right. Yeah. Good.
They do now.
That's right. Okay.
So.
Right. So I've been visiting you guys for decades now, and when I look around the house, I see a lot of the art is gone. I hear you guys had a great big sale this past weekend.
It was huge. It was Saturday and Sunday. Mm-hmm. And we sold a lot of smaller things on Saturday, and
I sold a lot of my sculpture on Sunday. So we had some rainy weather here, wasn't as many people, but it's like Sunday everybody bought something.
Now, bigger ticket items, actually. His sculptures are more expensive than my smaller pieces of art. So both days were very successful. And mm-hmm. we have some empty walls. The walls in my studio are empty, and your studio.
And under the bed where we had a lot of older artwork stored, all clean now.
Yep. I think even some furniture
that's
been sold and picked up.
1, 2, 3, 4, maybe 5 or 6 pieces of furniture, some small, some bigger. So
lamps.
Lamps, sort of little end table cabinet pieces, some stuff that I built, and other stuff that we have acquired over time. So, because we're not going to be taking a shipping container down to Costa Rica, we have to really minimize what we will ship.
So does that mean that you still have some artwork and some furniture left to sell?
Yes.
All right. So if I was interested or someone was interested in some of the things that are still here, how can they get a hold of these items?
Okay. So I have a YouTube channel as well, LorriMarie Jenkins, and I show my art pieces on there. And if ever you see something on there that you would like, you can leave a comment. My website, most of that stuff has been sold. I do need to get on there and update that, or have our website guru update that. But I guess the best way to do it is email. You know, email us, say, okay, you know, what do you have for sale? We can tell you, we can send pictures. We've been sending videos to people if they want to know what's for sale. Our appliances, which are just absolutely Cadillacs, will be selling with the house, which segues into the sale of the house.
Yeah.
And we'll be listing that.
That's going to be April.
Yeah.
Is that what you meant?
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Yeah.
So that's the goal, is to have it on the market. Early spring is a very good time to sell. And so if we do that in April, that still kind of ties in with our plans. We're looking to leave California on June 1st of next year. Mm-hmm. So a lot of spinning plates, a lot of balls in the air, and so we're just kind of chipping away at these things one at a time.
Yeah. So I've been watching your videos, and I know that you guys have been having your big sale and getting the house sale ready and doing a myriad of different tasks. So what's next? What's on your plate next?
Well, for me, I head off to Costa Rica in early January. I think it's January 5th. And I'm on a 2-week scouting expedition looking at areas where LorriMarie and I might want to relocate. And so I've talked a little bit about this. We're looking in the southern zone, San Isidro, Rivas area, over past Tinamaste to the Pacific coast. Dominical, Uvita, Ojo Chal, just all around there. And I'm hopefully going to find a place for LorriMarie and I to look at together. And when she comes down with me again in March. So January 5th is just about 2 weeks away. Yeah. And I need about 2 months to get as ready as I would like to be.
Yeah. So with travel restrictions and the way that the world seems to be changing, do you have any concerns about your upcoming travel?
Yes and no. There's things that are out of my control. There's things that are in my control, and I think I've done a pretty good job of doing those. One of the Airbnbs that I was going to stay at in Costa Rica canceled on me. So that's some of this weekend's work is, finding a place to stay. January is a big tourist time, so I don't want to have to pay an arm and a leg for a place. So, yeah, that's good.
It'd be really
good.
Hard to pack and get everything done if you had to pay for an arm and a leg.
I don't know. Maybe it'd be easier. Maybe I could load him up with more stuff.
But you raise a good point that there might be travel restrictions. We got the Omicron virus or whatever variant coming out, and I don't know how things might or might not change. Traveling to Costa Rica, I'm fully vaccinated. I know about the health pass I have to do in Costa Rica before I show up. I'm flying Delta, and Delta has a whole nice little checklist. They've got country by country requirements, so I'll be looking up all of this stuff ahead of time. So ideally, I don't have any surprises at the airport. Like, no, you can't go.
Yeah, and I think that that's great advice, is to always check with the airline.
Yeah.
And the advice I can give too is print it out.
Yeah.
Print everything that you think you need and more.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Just keep checking those websites.
Yeah. Yeah.
And Hudson, what's coming up next for you?
I have to go see the vet. So I am, Jennifer, myself, Hudson, and just the three of us are heading up to Dixon on Monday for a meet and greet with his USDA vet. I chose to have a meet and greet appointment so that the next appointment, which will be a couple weeks before we leave, they're already familiar with him and know we've already taken care of anything that needs to be taken care of rather than waiting until the last minute. So Dixon is about 45 minutes away from us, and I'll be glad for the company, and I'll be glad to have Hudson meet and greet the vet. So that's good.
So that's Hudson's paperwork, but in your videos, you guys have also talked about birth certificates and marriage certificates and having to get a certain type of I would say apostolization.
I know. Exactly.
Going to see the apostles for us.
Right. So we did. I'm not going to talk about this. You
okay.
Guys. Okay.
Perfect.
Okay. I want you to talk about it.
What's that?
Want me to talk about it?
Sure. You want to?
What are you talking about? What are you talking about, Willis?
So this is the federal document. You can see the little. Not a paperclip. It's actually
a grommet.
There.
Wallace and Grommet.
Yep. So it's Department of Justice, Federal Bureau of Investigation. Those of you who watch TV might know that's FBI. So we have, and it's called an apostille.
Yep.
Is that correct? And this was for LorriMarie's birth certificate.
This is for our FBI background check.
The fingerprints. Oh, I remember that video.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. And so this is a very heavy cardstock document here, and it's got a seal here that's, we're all the same family, same sense of humor. And it's the type where it goes into the machine that presses, and it's like an embossed,
mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it's actually raised. So it's not a sticker, it's not a stamp. It's actually a raised stamp there. And you'll be doing this for other documents as well?
We have a total of 5 documents, and we need these because we are applying for residency.
Mm.
If you're just going on a tourist visa, it's a very different scenario. We chose to go the residency route, and so the 5 documents that we have to have for our residency are background check for LorriMarie and I, each, marriage certificate, my birth certificate, and LorriMarie's birth certificate. And each of these five documents all has to have their own apostille from either the state where it comes from.
Right, my birth certificate is Oakland.
So you got your birth certificate, Oklahoma. But then you have to send it back.
Correct.
So back to a different department to get the apostille.
Yes.
Correct. Okay.
And so the FBI background checks that we had done, we have gotten both of these back from the Washington, D.C. Secretary of State. So these are the first forms we've gotten that are ready to go. This is ready for Costa Rica.
So you handle all of this by mail?
No, in person.
Oh.
In person. These have...
You took this in person?
Oh, no. To Costa Rica, we take it in person.
So the apostille process is you get the document and then you mail it to the proper department.
Yes.
And then they mail it back to you.
Yes.
And I remember something about your birth certificate. It had to be valid for six months before. So is there a time period on these as well?
Everything. All of these documents have to be less than 6 months old when we apply for residency. And fingers crossed, we're doing that in March. So I actually had to get a new birth certificate from Florida because when I first got one, I was all excited and it was going to be just a little bit too early. Mm-hmm. It's going to be more than 6 months. And so LorriMarie and I have each gotten our birth certificates. Hers from Oakland.
Oklahoma.
Mine from Florida. And our marriage certificate is here in California. Once we got those certified documents, they all had to go to the secretaries of state
Oklahoma, Florida, and California. Right.
And we are waiting on all of those, not knowing when they are going to come back. None of the checks that I sent have been cleared yet. Even the check for the FBI one hasn't cleared. But we got the paperwork back, so.
That's good news. At least you're getting the paperwork.
Right. Okay. So, we don't know what's going on. Federal, I mean, everybody is a little slower due to COVID, and then now the holidays. So,
right.
Yeah.
And then Chinese New Year, you know.
I know,
there's always something. Yeah. So, between the big sale and constantly purging and documentation, and veterinary, just curious, you know, I've done this move, well, not this move, but mm-hmm. I've moved overseas. I've been overseas for 20 years. Stress level, how are we doing?
It's stressful.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's stressful. I mean, I'd like to say that everything is smooth as satin, but it's not.
Mm-mm.
Communication is hard. Feelings were fragile.
Fragile.
Italian.
Mm-hmm.
It's Italian. Yeah, okay. It's overwhelming. And sometimes communication is not very clear. And when it's questioned, people get snappy and it's hard.
Yeah. LorriMarie is still pretty much holding a full workload of classes and selling artwork and putting videos up. I'm still working full time at my job and we're doing all this stuff in the meantime.
It's like having two full-time jobs.
Right.
It is.
With a very definite timeline.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's like we have an end date for this, so we know what we have to do. And there's times where it's like, well, I feel a little behind right now. And that's when it's easier to get kind of stressed out.
Yep.
Wow. I'd say one thing that we're doing that is helping us a lot is we're pretty much not doing anything big around the holidays.
I thought you were going to say, we're not doing anything else.
No,
we're not doing anything else.
Well,
we're getting ready, together with family.
Yes, yes, but
a little bit.
Presents for each other. We saw the Christmas tree.
Yes. So.
That's good. But yep.
Yep. One day at a time around here.
Mm-hmm. So communication is key, whether it's by mail or in person with the mail.
yep. Absolutely.
Communicate. Okay, yeah. Right, yeah, all right, okay, well, we wish you the best on everything. Thank you. And again, you're not alone. I know that you have people that are helping you and you're paying it forward and helping other people as well, so yeah, yeah.
Thanks for hanging with us. Thanks, Jennifer. Okay. All right, all right, see.
Adios.
All right,
ciao,
bye.